Talking about trying new things. Check. Trying a new thing. Check. Serendipitously meeting a crush somewhere you didn't expect. Check. Running away from responsibilities. Double check. A story about kindergarten. Check. And procrastination. Checkmate. Okay, what other hashtag relatable things can I talk about as I slowly lose my soul? I know, how about the time I got robbed by my ex-classmate and was mentally scarred for a few weeks? Months. A few months. Hashtag relatable! No? Do people not get robbed by their ex-classmates? Just me? And maybe a few other people? Oh. Victor A? D! By the way, this isn't a joke. This isn't a, oh man, my friend borrowed some money from me and didn't pay it back. Shucks. No, I was literally mugged. Granted, it was only $2, but still anxiety inducing. Another mental scarring for my psychiatrist aside, this is how it happened. As you guys may know, I was a skater boy, mainly through middle school and the beginning of high school. My friends and I would skate at a park near our houses almost daily, and near that park was a shop where we used to buy soda in between playing skate or clearing gaps. Or not clearing gaps. Well, one day, while I was on my way back from finishing some nice Coke. Wrong Coke. Yeah, this one. Uh-huh. On my way back, I heard one of my names being called. From elementary to middle school, I used to go by a different part of my incredibly long name. So for this to make sense, let's say they yelled out the A from Victor A.
A, over here!
So I turn around and eventually find a car with an open door. And there's two suspicioso-looking people sitting in it, looking suspicious. I immediately recognize the guy in the driver's seat as a classmate from elementary. Let's call him Az, because he's the one who's going to rob me in this story. So let's face it, he's an Az. Family friendly. And by the way, we were 13 or 14 at the time. Too young to drive legally, so I have no idea why he was in the driver's seat. Well, clearly up to no good. So Az says, "How you been, eh?" I answer and ask him the same question. And you know when people say hi to you, but you don't want to talk to them? Yeah, that's how this conversation was going. I had nothing to say to this person, and we didn't really talk when we were classmates, so I wanted to get the hell out of Dodge. Oh, if only I knew. But before I could even utter, "Alright, well, nice talking, bye!"
Cha-la-la-la-la.
He says, "Don't move. I have a gun. Right here."
What am I gonna do?
And so I froze. And died. But really, I'm gonna have to leave you guys for that cliffhanger. This video is getting too long, and if I keep going, I won't be able to finish it on time. So I hope you guys understand. But the second part will be ready by next Thursday, so hit the sub button and bell icon for now to be notified for the thrilling conclusion of my psycho ex-classmate mentally scarring me for life, part 2. Thanks, and until next time, bye!